Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today in this video I'm going to show you how to fix crashing and freezing issue with Saints Row the third remastered game on your computer. Now there are multiple steps, so at the end of each step try to launch the game. In case still you are facing the problem, then move on to the next step. Now the first step is to close the game, restart your computer and launch the game. So with me this has worked, so it might work for you. So if the game is running, close the game, restart your computer and then try launching the game once again. In case still you are facing the problem, then run the game as an administrator. To run the game as an administrator, go to the game installation folder. So in my case, I have installed the game in D drive. So go to the game installation folder and then open the game folder. And once you open the game folder, make a right click on the game exe file and then select properties and then go to the compatibility tab and then put a check on option which says run this program as an administrator. So put a check over here, then click on apply, OK, and then try launching the game. Now still you are facing the problem, then when you are playing the game, you can go ahead and disable this feature only when you are playing the game. After you are done playing, you can go ahead and enable this feature. First of all, you have to go ahead and disable the antivirus. So if you have any antivirus running, maybe AVG, McAfee, Norton, Avast, so any antivirus which is running, go ahead and disable the antivirus. Also disable the Windows firewall. To disable Windows firewall, go to the settings, open Windows 10 settings, go to update and security, then click on Windows security, then click on firewall and network protection, then click on allow an app through firewall, and then click on Windows Defender firewall over here, click on it. And then click on turn Windows Defender firewall on or off. Turn off, put a check on turn off Windows Defender firewall, turn off Windows Defender firewall. Now this is not recommended, but only while playing the game you can go ahead and turn off this feature and then click on OK. Now once you are done playing the game, you can always go ahead and enable the Windows firewall. You can go ahead and enable and then click on OK. And then you can now the next is to disable control folder access. So to disable control folder access, open settings once again, go to update and security, click on Windows security, click on virus and threat protection, and then click on manage ransomware protection, then go ahead and disable this feature which says control folder access, and then try launching the game. Now still you are facing the problem, then empty the language code. So to empty the language code, open File Explorer, go to the game installation folder where the game is installed, and you have to open the game folder, and then here you can see the language. So you have to open it with Notepad. So click on open with Notepad, and here you can see the language code. So here in my case, I can see EN as in English. So I will go ahead and empty this. So I go ahead and empty this folder, this Notepad, and then click on save. And then you can go ahead and try launching the game. This has also worked for me. And the next step is to set the right resolution. So go ahead and check what is the resolution for your monitor or your laptop. So make a right click, then click on display settings. And then here you can see display resolution is 1920 to 1080 in my case. It may be 4K with you. So whatever is the display resolution, set the right resolution in the game. So open File Explorer. And then go to the game folder once again, open the game folder, and here you will see the display. Here you can see the display file. So you might not be able to see this. If you're not able to see this, then on the top you will see the view option. So click on view, then you have to put a check on which option which says hidden item. So you have to put a check over here. So go ahead and put a check, and in that case, you know, the display may appear. So make a right click, then click on open with Notepad, and here you can see the resolution width is 1920 1080. So you have to match with your monitor or laptop. So here 1920 1080, and here also I have set 1920 1080. So make sure that the resolution is correctly set, then click on save, and then you can go ahead and try launching the game. Now still you are facing the problem, then you have to go ahead and do a clean installation of your graphic driver. To do a clean installation, if you have AMD, go to AMD website. If you have NVIDIA, go to NVIDIA. So in my case, I'm showing for NVIDIA. I have NVIDIA. So just type in NVIDIA drivers in Google search. Go to NVIDIA website. then select your graphic card from the list. Make sure that you select your graphic card. If you're not aware, make a right click on the start menu, then click on Device Manager. Expand the Display Adapter option in the Device Manager, and here you'll be able to see your graphic card. So select your graphic card from the list, then click on Search, then click on Download. And once you click on Download, you have to go ahead and run the .exe file, which will download. Now, once the download is complete, you have to run the .exe file, then you will see this screen. Click on Agree and Continue, then you have to select the option which says Custom, then click on Next. Put a check on option which says Perform a Clean Installation. So once you put a check over here, then click on Next. It will go ahead and do a clean installation of your graphic card driver, and that may fix the problem. The second next step is to for laptop users with dual graphic card. So if you have a laptop and it has a dual graphic card, so here in my case I've shown you that my laptop has a dual graphic card. One is Intel, other is Nvidia. So for laptop users, just make sure that you're running the game on dedicated graphic card. So make a right click on your desktop, then click on Nvidia control panel, and then go to Manage 3D settings, then go to Program settings, click on Add, then select the game from the list. If you don't find the game over here, then click on Browse. Go to the game installation folder, open the game folder, then select the .exe file, and then click on Open. And then here you see the option which says select the preferred graphics processor for this program. Click on this down arrow and select high performance NVIDIA processor, then click on Apply. On the bottom right you will see the Apply option. Click on Apply, and once this is done, you can go ahead and try launching the game. Now still you are facing the problem, then you have to perform clean boot. To perform clean boot, you have to go ahead and type in system configuration in Windows search box, and then click on system configuration. Go to services tab, then put a check on hide all Microsoft services. Put a check over here. Once you put a check over here, then click on disable all, then click on apply, OK, and then restart your computer and then try launching the game. The next step is to repair the game in Epic Games Launcher. So go to the Epic Games Launcher library, then you have to go ahead and click on the three dots which is there on Saints Row, the third remastered game title. So on the bottom you will see the three dots, so click on it and then click on verify. Once the verification is done, you can go ahead and launch the game. If nothing works for you, then go ahead and uninstall and reinstall the game. So one of the steps should definitely help you to go ahead and fix the crashing and freezing issue with the game. So that will be all. Thank you so much for your time, and please like this video and subscribe to my channel.